One West Magazine, One West Radio. It's your boy Damian Sanders, P-Flix, holding it down for the West Coast, man. Shouts out to my big homie OG Suicide, laying this One West Magazine foundation down. We got a special guest in the house today, man, doing it real big. One of the West best all day long. We got CJ Mack in the house, man. How you doing, big OG?
Yes, sir. What's up, Damian? How you feel, man? One West.
Man, I'm chilling, man. Just hanging in there, man. First of all, it's an honor to have you on the phone, man. I appreciate you taking this phone call all day long.
No, I appreciate you having me, brother. I really, really appreciate it.
All day. So, now, first off, how was you introduced to hip-hop music, and what was your inspiration to get started?
Oh, man, it's crazy. You know what? I'm going to tell you the truth. I normally don't spit the real deals about that because it was, you know, kind of like a compromising situation. But, you know, I had gotten in some trouble for my very, very first time, man, to tell you the truth. And I'm not going to say my age at the time, but I was in juvenile hall, man. I was sitting on the edge of my bunk. And I heard, yeah, I had already heard Rapper's Delight and all that, and I like that. I learned the words and all that. But, man, I heard Melly Mel, man, the message. It's like a jungle sometimes. It makes you wonder, you know, and I had got in trouble for something pretty serious, right? And that turn stick up kid, look what she done did, got sent up for 8-year bid.
Yeah.
Man, that got me, man. God bless me, and I didn't get in trouble for what I was accused of, you know. And I love rap after that. That was it.
Now I can dig it. Now you released your first project, Color Me Funky. Is that correct?
Yeah. That was my first project. I had the influence of those guys, man. You know, the Big Daddy Kanes and the LL Cool J's and the Run DMC's, you know. I used to run up and down the freeway back and forth between L.A. and Hill and Empire doing what I was doing, you know, and listening to them guys, you know. So my rap was influenced by them at first. So I put out a little project trying to learn a game independently and everything. And, you know, I did what I could with that. Went to Atlanta, you know, started pushing it out, doing what I could. And I just came back home and started doing what I do.
Now, I can dig it. Now, then you put out the album, man, True Game. You was with Rap-A-Lot Records at the time. Tell us about your experience being out there in Texas working with Jay Prince.
Oh, it was a wonderful experience because Jay Prince is a teacher, man. You know, so he and I were really, really good friends, man. Like, we really took to each other, you know. Like a lot of other people used to be staying at, like, we were, you know, a few of us were out there from L.A., so we stay at hotels and everything. I used to stay at the house with Jay, or either at the ranch, you know. We became really, really close friends. He explained the ins and outs of the business to me, so that was a wonderful experience. Plus, he was the first person to trust me, man. Like, you know, he... Scarface had a song, Never Seen a Man Cry Until I Seen a Man Die. You know, I heard the song and everything, and I told Lewis what I wanted to do with it, you know, and I had never directed a video or anything like that before. I had no experience whatsoever. He called me the next day and said, hey, remember those ideas you had for the video? I said, yeah. He said, cool, you directing the video. So he trusted me, man, like, you know, he trusted me to do that video, and he put the right technical people around me and everything, and, you know, I respect him from, you know, that day forward.
Now, I definitely want to speak on this, man. It's one of my favorite movies. I watch the movie all the time, still to this day, Thicker Than Water.
Okay.
Now, tell us, you know, how you got involved in that project, and what was that experience like working in that movie?
Well, first of all, Mac 10, y'all got to give Mac 10 love. And, you know, Dub C, Ice Cube, and everybody, the whole family. Well, Mac 10 and I kind of had a little pact before he got on. You know, he was with DJ Pooh and doing some things that I was doing, And we kind of told each other, man, whoever get on first, man, we're going to look out for each other. So even though I had did the Rap-A-Lot deal and everything, Priority Records had, you know, they had fat in Mac 10 pockets, you know. And Mac 10 came and got me, you know. Like, I was one of the first ones he signed. He came and got me. He kept his word. So we did that, and he decided to go off and venture and start making movies. So actually, the role I played was supposed to be for Master P.
Wow.
Master P was supposed to play Gator. In some kind of way, that didn't happen. So I went in there and auditioned for the role, and they gave it to me. You know, and I just kind of took off, you know. Part of that role was easy for me because it was my life, right?
Hey, man.
But the hard part was being from Louisiana. You know, I learned a lot from the director, Richard Cummings, on that. He taught me, you know, some secrets that I use to this day, you know, about using my eyes and things like that, man. So that was a wonderful experience as well.
Hey, you played that part, man. You did a really good job all day.
Thank you. I appreciate that.
Now, let's get into this. Now, you got the new book coming out right now, 80s Baby.
Yeah. So what I'm doing with the book, man, is, first of all, it's going to be a book that's going to be something that I've never done before as far as the audio version of the book. I can't go into too much detail with that, but I promise you that I'll get back on here, you know, with One West, man, and talk to you about it first. But I'm doing something, man, that's really, really going to be innovative and something brand new with the audio portion of the book. And other than that, the book is a way for me to still spit, man. I'm not 18 anymore, 21 years old, so I don't necessarily want to get out there and competing with my youngsters, you know what I'm saying? Like, I love all of them, all the L.A. young kids and everywhere else. I love what they doing, you know? Whether they do the same type of music I was doing or not, you know, you got to grow. If you can't grow, it's over. So, you know, I grow right along with them kids. You know, I still hang out with them. I'm still with them. But what I'm doing with the book is my way to express myself, to still tell my street stories, to still tell my street tales. And not only that, I'm offering opportunities for other gentlemen that are locked up, you know what I mean, that were from my era and even young guys, you know, that don't have outlets. I'm going to be the West Coast outlet for these books. But my book, 80s, baby, basically, you know, it's about the 80s, baby, and the way things are going on back then, you know. And it's a true story, man. It's going to be really shocking, man, in my writing abilities. I get to see who I am. I'm a writer first. Whether it's rap music, whether it's movies, whether it's television scripts, you know, books, I'm a writer. You know, and a writer must write his thoughts and not say them. So now I'm to the point in an age where it's time for me to write them and not just say them.
Now I can dig that. Now you answer my next question already, is you being an outlet for other aspiring rappers to get their work out there. They can definitely holler at you.
Well, definitely, man. I'm doing a soundtrack. I'm doing 80s baby soundtrack, and what I'm gonna be doing with that is, it's gonna be me. I'm gonna get out a little bit, you know. I'm gonna come out of retirement and get out, cause I still can. I still think I'm hard. But now, yeah, I'm gonna have a bunch of the kids, man, that was, you know, basically from the 80s era. You know, these new kids that's out here now, you know, I got to start filming them. So they're gonna be all over my soundtrack too. You know, so, you know, a lot of them are supporting me and what I'm doing. And so you're gonna hear some amazing music, man, from amazing talent on the soundtrack as well. So I'm putting out a book soundtrack, downloadable version of the book, and also an audio version.
Now you got
so
the web.
A large project.
Now you got the website going up soon, cjmaxbooks.com, yeah, as well.
Yes, I do. Yes, I do. Got the website. They have all the information on how to order, and we're gonna do some really, really, really clever and fun marketing things, man, that we're putting together right now. And I mean, this is gonna be big, man. We're gonna have a ball doing this, man. And also, you know, we're gonna serve public. Now, yeah, man. You know, the biggest thing is I want to promote literacy also, man. It's easy to pop a CD and change it, you know, or download some music, man. You know, I want to kind of get people reading. I want to give them an exciting way to read. Everybody got headphones on and all that, so I want to be able to listen to this book and enjoy it so much that they want to go ahead and pick up the long version. You know, it's kind of like when someone writes a book and that book gets broken down to a movie, you know, a 90-minute movie. You know, sometimes that inspires you. Well, I want to see what the book was about. Then you read the book and see the book was even better. So that's kind of what I want to, you know, that's kind of what I want to influence. And I want to promote literacy, man, throughout our community.
I can definitely dig that. Now, once again, this is One West Magazine, One West Radio. We live and in charge and doing it big. We got big OG CJ Mac in the house representing with us. Now, as being a well-respected OG, how do you feel about the state of the West Coast right now and hip-hop as it is right now?
You know, I like the dudes that's doing their thing, man. YG, you know, my little homeboy Nipsey Hussle, Game still holding it down. You know, you still got a whole lot of people, a whole lot more upcoming artists. Glasses Malone, you know, a whole bunch of kids, man. I really get down with Topic. You know, a kid out of Moreno Valley by the name of Faze Luciano. He's dope. Y'all gonna hear about him, man. And, you know, I love what they're doing, man. You know, I'm not one of those men that I'm knocking what everybody else is doing, you know? But, you know, when I came out, Melly Mel was my favorite rapper, okay? Melly Mel from Grandmaster Flash and Fuse 5. He might not like the fact that I was cussing when my songs came out, right? He might not like the fact that I wasn't saying at the end. You know what I'm saying? So I can't get mad because the times change and okay, it's ratchet music now and this now. I can't get mad at the youngsters for doing what they do. If I can't get with it, then I'm supposed to go home because it's over for me. If I can't adapt to what's going on, then it's over for me. You know what I'm saying? So I'm not mad at them for keeping it alive. You might not. People that love music from my era may not like all the new stuff that's going on, but you can't hate on these kids for continuing on, because that's just what it is.
Definitely can't do that. Now, for out of your whole career, of all the tracks that you've recorded, what's your favorite joint out there that you dig the most?
I'm in my sister right now.
I mean,
let my knees out the pen, man, because that was real dear to my heart. Like, you know, a lot of my homeboys, you know, I'm from that 80s era, you know, so a lot of my homeboys is getting scooped up and getting locked up that didn't make the same decisions that I did, you know, and I'm a blessed one. Like, you know, God blessed me, and I didn't end up where they ended up, but I was losing a whole lot of friends at the time. I was losing friends to the 3-strike law and family members. I was losing homeboys to, you know, drugs, you know, getting 35 years. For 1,000 grams, you know what I mean? I just thought that punishment was unjust, and they still in jail. You know what I mean? So it was dead serious about it, and they still in jail. You know, and I was really, really hurt by that, and it affected me. So that was my way to talk about it, and that was my release for that.
Okay, now we know that you've had the opportunity to work with a lot of artists out there over your career. Now, is there anybody out there still that you would most love to collaborate with?
Man, you know who I like, man, somebody I haven't worked with, but I talk to a lot, man, and may or may not surprise you, Gang.
Okay.
I love Gang, man, like, that's my little guy, man, and for some reason, like, we always went, you know, everything he invites me to, whether it's clubs or party, you know, we pop bottles together, I get sections right next to him, and, you know, we from different areas of the city, that don't matter, you know, his homeboys always respect me, my respect him, you know, we get down and hang out and everything, and he said something, he opened up to me one day, he said, man, you know what, when I was in the 5th grade, I had your first CD. I mean, it was a cassette then. He said, I had it in my Walkman. He said, I listened to you every day. You was my favorite rapper when I was in the 5th grade.
Man, that's real right there. I know that happened in a lot.
That tripped me out. Yeah, that tripped me out. You know what I mean? So I haven't done anything with Game, man. I really want to do something with Game on the soundtrack.
Now you make sure if y'all make that happen, that One West Radio get that first.
Yeah, I got to, man. You know, I got to ask my little brother for that favor, man. And I don't think he's going to turn me down.
Yeah, I can dig it now. Before we go, is there any shout-outs you want to throw out there right quick?
Well, I just want to shout-out, man, to the whole game itself, man. For you guys, you know, at One West, keeping it alive and hitting the airwaves to the Sting, man, and the magazine and everything. I salute y'all, man, for, you know, being businessmen and also putting out the word and keeping everything alive. Because, you know, the pendulum swings back and forth. Sometimes we hot, sometimes we not over here. You know, and that's how it goes. You know, this is a business that's not really run by a whole bunch of West Coast executives. So everything that you guys can do to keep it alive is going to keep it alive. I want to give a shout out to, you know, the entire city of Los Angeles and the whole West Coast, because I love it. You know what I mean? I'm lost. I'm L.A. everything, man. L.A. Lakers, L.A. Clippers. Hey, whoever they bring for an expansion team with football, I'm on them too. I'm 100% L.A., man. So I just want to shout out to everybody and thank y'all.
Hey, all day long, man. It's been a pleasure, OG. I appreciate it.
Thank you, man. Thank you very much.
One West Magazine, One West Radio.
One West, baby. Giving my niggas second chances and brand new flights.